Come, Holy Spirit, come fill my heart, refresh my soul.
This is your season of grace with your host, Patrick Henry Edet. Get ready for Grace Revolution.
And so, Father, I thank you for the administration of your word. Your word has never been a suggestion. Your word carries eternal imperative. The power that causes things to be and things that are but are not according to your pattern. The power that causes them to fade away and disappear. I stand in full awareness of Christ as your image. That in him, your eternal power has been revealed. I stand in awareness that called in Christ to preach your name and reflect your image and represent your kingdom and your government. And Lord, I have no power except you. I have no ambition except you. I have no purpose. I have no vision. I have no plan, no desire. I seek no reward except you yourself. And so, Lord, by your Holy Ghost, let the whole of the sacrifice of your Christ come to manifest your will in every life that is sitting here and will sit here now and always, every time until the Christ comes when we gather, that your pleasure will prosper through the sacrifice, obedience of your servant, the Christ, and in the full administration of the Holy Ghost. Lord, see me. If you are looking for somebody, I donate me. I accept you and your purpose. And concerning these ones here, that everyone will resemble you tonight and resemble your plan and become your plan in the name of Jesus. If you agree, say, I accept it. Okay. You see, faith is what allows God to be a God in your life. Write it down. Faith allows God to be God in your life. God is God with you or without you. But it is by faith that you allow God, who is almighty, to be mighty and almighty in your life. The measure of your faith determines the measure of the manifestation of God in your life. Am I talking to somebody? The scripture says, without faith, no one can please God. Exodus chapter 14. Exodus chapter 14. From verse 10, as Pharaoh approached, the Israelites looked up, and there were the Egyptians marching after them. The Egyptians. This is the context of Exodus, leaving Egypt. Why many people cannot advance? Because they cannot face what it takes to move from Egypt towards the promised land. As soon as you are ready to cross to the other side, there is a storm waiting for you, locking behind in the sea. And once you get into the middle of the sea, wind plus storm, they come together and they become windstorm. And some people, once they get to that level, they begin to go down. Even with Jesus, he said, he's a child of God. But why should a child of God be? Who don't want me being out and dead to me? And all that and all that. God cannot be mocked. He knows those who are his own. The testimony of one man shouldn't discourage you because you don't know who that person is. Don't let the bad testimony of any believer discourage you. Let the word of God make you. Because I can be standing here and preaching. If I'm not right with God, the word of God will not work for me. No matter how much I do open eye. There are Egyptians that have enjoyed you staying in that one place for too long. Egyptians, they enjoy the slavery because the slavery gives them free labor. Who doesn't like it? When we talk about witchcraft, you don't understand the works of witchcraft. Witchcraft is a world. Darkness is a world. So when you see people's story, there are walls, another life behind it. If your eyes were to be open to see a life that is behind the sin of the people that walk around, you will cry. That's why you need to be truly circumcised in the Holy Ghost to walk in discernment, where your eyes can be opened and you discover a pattern and you rise against that pattern. God has used it to save me. How you can walk and your eyes are open to see patterns that have been there in your life destroying you and you didn't know. And because you know, you can fight. You don't fight what you don't know. Stand up and lift up your right hand. I pray the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ to open your eyes so that you may see what will activate and begin your journey of advance in the name of Jesus. Amen, 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 amen. Be seated. Revelation. Pharaoh is always trying to get back. Get back people who want to run away. Get back people who are advancing into marriage. Some people, they get so close, but Pharaoh catches up with them. And they begin to call it disappointment. Everything has diagnosis, but the issue is, what is the foundation? The foundation can be spiritual, can also be physical. So when a doctor says you have cancer, that is diagnosis. But there can be a spiritually generated cancer. In the case, how do you explain a case of a woman that has been married to a man for years and has a son that is about 12 years or so, 11, 12 years, suddenly the son is diagnosed of HIV. The mother diagnosed is HIV positive, but the father is not. Suddenly, because somebody took heal. In taking heal, say, let's check what happened. Oh, these days we have to check everything. 11-year-old boy, you alone come get HIV. The other people that follow you, they don't have it. Your mother has it. Your father does not have it. You tell me it's medical. Now I say, yes, it's true, it's medical. A provocation that manifests, it is called phenomenon. A phenomenon from the Greek root is what appears. What is seen? Am I talking to somebody? What appears does not tell you what makes it appear. You only see what appears and you give a name to it and respond to it and begin to live according to it, because that is what appears. They say, I am sick. So I am sick. Couldn't talk because I am sick. No, I will not go to church this evening because I am sick. It appears. And you respond to it. You walk according to it. You talk according to it. But you don't know what shows it. Because what shows it could just be that the desire is to cause you to walk in a particular way. So there is a generation of appearance phenomenon. And you begin to act accordingly. And give a name to it. Lift up your tongue and everything that appears in your life that God is not the generator, let it die in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, everything that appears in my life that does not have its origin from you, let it die. I shall not live according to what appears that does not come from you. I shall not walk according to what appears that does not come from you.
I shall not dance according to what appears and does not come from him. In the name of Jesus, be seated. In the army, those who train people, when they want you to somersault, they say somersault. So there could be an intention for your marriage to somersault. And so there is a projection of something that will condition you to somersault. And so you begin to somersault. He said, what happened? He said, not this. He did this. He did this. He did this. It appeared. But you don't know where it came from. But the scripture says we are not fighting against flesh and blood. That means we are not fighting against what appears. We are fighting against the roots of the appearance. The simulators. The generators. Go and begin to pray. As you go from tonight, if you have not been praying, begin to pray into your life. So, Lord, take me into the place of the generators of what appears in my life. Give me, the scripture says, who will take me face to face with Edom? Who will take me to Edom? Edom is a place that you have to fight. But who will take you there? Is it not you, the Almighty? It takes God to take you to what you need to see. I love the Holy Spirit. The scripture says it trains my hands for battle. It trains my fingers for war. Glory to God. There's a supernatural that God is taking things off the eyes of somebody. The curtain wool that covered your eyes and kept you like in a state of embalmment. Whatever kept you like in lying in state and make people relate with you as if you are lying in state, as if you are dead, I take the wool off your eyes. I take it off your nose. I take it off your ears. Rise and walk. I say rise and walk. Wherever you are, just rise and walk around. Just rise and walk. Rise and walk. Rise and walk. You are not lying in state. Whoever that people see you as if you are lying in state, I say it's not true. Lift up your hand and say, it is not true. I am not lying in state. You see that? The scripture says the Egyptians marched after them. Every Egyptian that is marching after you, that's why you need to be separated from darkness. You see, before God asked the people of Israel to leave Egypt, something happened. A lamb was slain. I'm sharing mystery with you. There is no advance until the lamb is slain, until the blood is shed. You see, God cannot change his arrangement because of you. You must change to fit the arrangement of God. The arrangement of God, before in Exodus chapter 12, God brought the people of Israel to the reality of Passover sacrifice, the first Passover. He told them, let every household take a lamb. And for a household that cannot eat one full lamb, that because of smallness in size, let that household share with another. At twilight, slaughter the lamb. Use the blood. Tell somebody, use the blood. There's no redemption without blood. Use the blood, put it upon the lintel, the pools of your house. Use the blood. For in the house that I will find, concerning the house that I will find the blood, I will do what? That means deliverance is given to you as portion because of the blood. And if I pass over you, it means nothing can harm you. For I am the superintendent general of life. If I don't authorize harm, harm does not come. So if I don't harm you, you are free. If you have peace with me, nothing can fight you. That's what God was telling them. The blood is a seal of peace and ownership. My ownership over you and your peace with me. Another life has been taken for your life. The lamb substituted. You see, Christ is the Lamb of God. John chapter 1 verse 29. The scripture says, on the following day, when John saw Jesus, he pointed, he said, there, behold him, the Lamb of God. He takes away the sins of the world. He had to die. The blood had to be shed. Whoever accepts him becomes a household that the blood is sealed. The blood of ownership, it means that one is now owned by God. It's the property of the federal government of heaven. And it means the ones who dwell therein, they have peace with Jehovah. He's their shalom. And if he's their peace, no weapon fashioned against them shall prosper. That was why God knew that the Egyptians would come. But because they had been redeemed, life had been exchanged. There had been a substitution. Blood had been shed concerning them. They had been ransomed and paid for. And they carried the seal of God's ownership. And nations were forbidden from touching them. Touch not my anointed. To my prophets, do no harm. I will fight those who fight you. I will be enemy to those who are your enemies. Whoever seeks your life will eat his flesh and drink his blood. That's the word of God for his children. Very certain. That's where I live. I live in that word. And so when Pharaoh was coming, the arms of flesh cannot harm you. They were coming marching after them. They were terrified and cried out to the Lord. Why? Because they did not know. They didn't know who their owner was. They didn't know who their protector was. They didn't know who their shepherd was. They didn't know whose flock they were. They cried. That's why knowledge is everything. Hearing the word of God and understanding the dynamics of the word of God and walking in it is deliverance. And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Glory to God. That's a generation that God wants to beget. A generation of knowledge and revelation. Paul praying for the Ephesians. Go and look at the prayer of Paul for the Ephesians and the Colossians. One thing in common, that God may open your eye, that you may come to have knowledge and be strengthened with the might of God, being conformed to all his will. Knowledge. Knowledge. Not empty prophecy. Empty prophecy that does not change a wicked man into a good man. Empty prophecy that does not change an envious person to a generous person. Revelation of the word of God. Because if your heart is at peace with somebody in the office who is looking for evil against you, Ebenezer brings charm to that office. You march in and march out. Why? You don't even know about it. You don't even pray about it because you don't have hate in your heart towards that person. The person considers himself or herself as your enemy, but you are not the enemy. Since that thing is meant for the enemy, that thing is meant for the enemy, but you are not an enemy. For you are just a colleague in the office. He is a brother and a sister. You pray for him. You love him. You don't have issues with whatever. There was a misunderstanding. But and then who can share a space without this misunderstanding? You don't hold it against that person. You don't wish evil. You don't have any problem. And somebody has problem and brings something. Whack. Since you are not the enemy, eventually the enemy enters it. The scripture says the one who digs the pit shall fall. It is knowledge. Knowledge. Since you are fighting in the level of hit me, I hate you, the one who is higher wins. But the scripture says the one who humbles himself will be lifted. It is not prophecy that makes you humble. It is knowledge of revelation.
when people are pushing, let him prophesy and let the sun stand still and rotate. After that, as a fornicator stops fornicating, no. He still fornicates after all the prophecy that mesmerized you. An age of deception. You are free in the name of Jesus. Stand up and lift up your hands and say, I am free. In the name of Jesus. Be seated. I agree with you, you are free. God knew something that they did not know. God knew these guys have been separated. God knew these guys have been consecrated. God knew these guys had become his own. And no Pharaoh had power over them. So God is not scared by witches and wizards. God doesn't worry about them. Because God knows of the substance that you are made of. He knows of the blood. Peter says, you know the blood that's for your redemption is not the blood. You were not redeemed of gold. You were not redeemed of some precious stuff. You were redeemed of the blood of the Lamb. So God knows the price he has paid for you. God knows what has gone into the making of you. God knows your substance. God trusts you. He trusts you can be delivered. He trusts that no circumstance is strong enough to destroy you. He trusts that in all these things you are more than conqueror. You see, God trusts you because he knows what has gone into making you. A builder of the bridge. Can I tell you something? In the ancient Roman Empire, engineers who build bridges, on the day of the inauguration of the bridges, the engineer has to stand under the bridge while they match everything to test the bridge. So if you trust in the bridge that you build, you go and stand under it. Lotoli Brazike Teliana. Engineers of today, almost everybody will die. That's the Roman Empire. That is why they were powerful. Roman Empire was not kwekwe empire. It was not. Was an empire built upon philosophy and knowledge. Understanding of law. Can you talk about law without Rome? Roman Empire. That's why if you go to law, it is Latin all over. Those guys had gone deep. This generation has to go deep. It is too superficial. So God is not afraid. God trusts you that when you stand under the bridge, he will not crush you because he knows the substance by which your salvation has been fabricated. He knows that no matter what crosses the bridge, you are unshakable. Am I talking to somebody? He knows cobweb can appear and disappear. He knows inwen can cry and die. He knows igrigir can cry and go off. The sun will rise and the sun will set. But he knows the substance is eternal. Your redemption is not temporal. It's eternal. Eternal means it has its origin and end beyond times. It never began and it will never end. That's why Jesus Christ says, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, so that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but will have what? Eternal. The word eternal means ever. Ever means ever before and ever after. Before, ever, recesses into the internal and into the future. The horizon cannot be seen. It is beyond. It means witches and wizards will come and cross. You are unshakable. Calabrazotelia. And so God is not afraid if you are in the same office with a wicked man. God is not afraid if you are sharing the same table with a wicked man. Because God knows the substance. God trusts the material. God trusts the bridge. Am I talking to somebody? Tell somebody God trusts the material. No, God has confidence in his work. Don't you see it in Genesis chapter 1? After creating, the scripture says, and God saw it and it was good. God has given signature. His signature is upon you. That you are good enough to endure tough times, to endure challenges, to endure everything that is thrown at you from hell. And you will be wondering, Papa says, come, mommy, and he allows this kind of thing. He knows you can go through it. That in all these things you are more than conqueror. What shall we say of all these things? He said, now more than ever,
that God wants to show the manifold wisdom of his glory through the church to the principalities and powers. Marching after them, it does not matter what is marching after you. God does not interrupt his rest. God is at rest. After saving you through Christ, God has rested. Jesus Christ testified, it is finished. Let the Father be on perpetual vacation. It is done. Unyanga mari, erika na mari, ufa amari uwo, eri uwo genkangi. The scripture says the grace of God has been revealed. He has taught men righteousness, how to separate themselves from. No, go to the next verse. The people of Israel, they cried out because they didn't know. God doesn't cry when you cry. They said to Moses, was it because there was no grave in Egypt that you brought us to the desert to die? What have you done to us by bringing us out of Egypt? Nonsense, talking nonsense. People like the idea, you think, when they pray, you think they are praying, they are talking nonsense. They said to Moses, was it because, didn't we say to you in Egypt, leave us alone, let us be stagnant forever, leave us alone, let us serve the Egyptians and be slaves forever, nonsense. It would have been better for us to serve the, from today, every nonsense from your mouth has been taken away. God knows you can make it. God knows you will make it. God knows by the stripes of his son, you have been healed. So he's not worried about your situation. Does not get worried. He's not. Glory to God. And let us continue in their nonsense. It would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians than to die in the desert. For them, they are seeing death. They didn't even know when the lamb died for them, their death had been killed. That's true. This thing that they now see, they say we want to die. God saw it and the lamb was slain for them. And so God has settled issues of their death. You cannot be in the train of God and see death. You don't. God has settled issue of death for them. So what they saw appearance. Did you hear what, when I talk about appearance? They saw what appeared. Mirage. They saw what appeared. And when the devil wants to confuse people, he begins to give them appearance. Appearance. God does not see appearance, he sees reality. Just God says, I am the way, the truth. Do you know what truth is? Reality as it is. So God sees things as it is. So he's not shaken by appearance. Moses answered the people, do not be afraid. I love it. If we have preached this revelation time and time again. Wonderful. But it is not God who said it though. They do not be afraid. Stand firm and you will see the deliverance the Lord will bring you today. Even Moses didn't know how it will happen. Just motivation and assurance. The Egyptians you see today, you will see no more. You will not see again. Praise God. Amen. This is not what I want to talk about. As exciting as that is, I'm not coming here to tell you what Moses said. Go further. Let's see what God said. Then the Lord comes. And he said, the Lord will fight for you. You need only to be still. This is what teachers do. This is what preachers do. Just make you, dispose you for God. But God is about speaking. That's why if after preaching to you, you don't hear God, you will not go foul. It is what God says that changes everything. After I have preached to you, I dispose you to hear from God. Because there is a day something tells you, ekwenge, and God says, rise and stand. Yep. Everything can tell you it is over. And a voice of God tells you it is the best time to be alive. Glory to God. For when they say there is a casting down, glory. The Lord will fight for you. Praise God. The next verse is why I wanted. Then the Lord said to Moses, you know this, God has something to say. God says something at last, and when he says something, something happens. Sometimes he does not say something when you are talking nonsense and crying, but at the end he will say something. Rise up on your feet.
Then the Lord said to Moses, why are you crying out to me? Is this the time to cry? Tell the Israelites to move on. Put it in New King James Version. And the Lord said to Moses, why do you cry to me? Tell the children of Israel to go forward. That means tell them to advance. Glory to God. Did you hear that? That's it. Whereas the Egyptians, the people of Israel see Egypt and death, God says, move forward. That means I see destiny ahead of you, move forward. I see children in the womb of the barren, move forward. God is saying, move forward. I see healing in front of you. No, it is not here. It is there. So advance, move forward. I see victory at the end of the tunnel. So move forward. Say, move, move. But the people of Israel were wondering. They said, where are we moving to? It is dark everywhere. Water in front of us. Egyptians behind us. This side, no way. This side, no way. Next verse. But lift up your rods and stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it. And the children of Israel shall go on dry ground through the midst of the sea. Which means when God says move forward, he has made provision. So you don't need to ask where. He has made provision. Where you see the sea is an appearance. Where you see an ocean standing against you is an appearance. Where you see a mountain is an appearance. God says, move forward. God trusts the power in the rod. He said, lift up the rod. Stretch it. We stretch it. And this is the beginning of it. This time around, Moses wants to do show. He stretched forth the rod. And the sea, they started recollection and retreat. And there was east wind blowing, and the ground was dry. And the people of Israel say, if we go in, what of if water? So go move forward. If you doubt, go back to the first word he said. What is the first word he said? Move forward. And they move forward. And you are moving forward. Amen. Lift up your right hand. You are moving forward. Amen. Just wave. I say, you are moving forward. Amen. You're moving forward. You're moving forward. You're moving forward. Just wave. Say, I'm moving forward. I'm moving forward. Children of God, move forward. If you don't know Jesus yet, accept the redemption of the blood. Accept Jesus. That's the forward. The forward, forward. Say, I'm moving forward. I'm moving forward. I am moving forward. The giver of life has spoken. He said, move forward. He has made a way for you. Is the way maker. Move forward. I say move forward. Continue to speak to your destiny. I'm moving forward. My business, I'm moving forward. My childbearing, I am moving forward. My husband, I'm moving forward. My wife, I am moving forward. My wedding dates, I am moving forward. My business, I am moving forward. My spiritual life, I am moving forward. I am moving forward in my dreams. I'm moving forward in my political project. But they said, where is the way? Yes, the one who says move forward is the way maker. Move forward, he has made a way. The scripture says he makes a way in the desert, a highway in the wilderness. Move forward, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed. Move forward, their fools shall not tread. Move forward, lions and wild beasts shall not be found. According to Isaiah chapter 35, move forward. The lame shall walk and rise. Move forward. The blind shall come and see. Move forward. Say, I am moving forward. Though the sea may appear before me, but by the rod of grace, the way has been parted for me. Move forward. No, I will not let you rest until you move forward. I'm moving forward out of sickness. He has made a way for my healing. I'm moving forward into my promotion. He has made a way for me, for my appointment, for my promotion, for my name. He has made room for me. He will not ask me to move forward if there were no provisions. He will not ask me to move forward if he had not made a way. He told Moses, I have a way in this wilderness. I have a way in this ocean. Raise your staff. The staff will part everything. Move forward from weakness into strength. Speak it out. Speak until you can say it. I move forward. I move forward into financial breakthrough. Apply your faith. I move forward from despair into hope. I move forward from joblessness. I move forward from failure. I move forward from begging. I move forward from struggling. Enough of slavery. I move forward. Prophesy your way through. The rod of Moses has parted the Red Sea. Move forward.
This program is sponsored by the Covenant Friends and Partners of Grace Family Global Outreach. You can be part of this grace revolution by becoming a Covenant Partner today. Allow God to use you. Our account details are as follows. Bank, Zenit Bank. Account name, Grace Family Global Outreach. Account number, 101-42-978-63. For inquiries, please call 081-804-33225 or 090-738-38742. To all our covenant partners and friends, we say thank you. Like the widow of Zarephath, your oil will never run dry. To order for the books, messages, and other resource materials, please call or send an SMS to 080-660-46346 or 081-804-33225. Videos are also available on YouTube at www.youtube.com/Grace Family Outreach. To stay connected, like us on Facebook at Grace Family Outreach or visit our website at www.gracecommission.org.